Who knows what evil lives in the heart of game? The Shadows knows.
Hi, I'm The Shadows Knows, and I'm back with another quick video. Tonight I'm going to composite mod this Specky, and I will also replace the keyboard membrane, so I can finally use this. So yeah, let's reposition the camera so I can actually, or you can actually see what I'm doing, and I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back, and I hope you can follow what I'm doing. Of course, first of all, remove all the screws. And that's by far the easiest part. So only those five screws. And then you should be able to open it. And I don't know if you can see it, but the cable is pretty degenerated. Yeah, the smaller one is completely snapped. That's how the Spectrum looks on the inside. And this here is the cooler, or the heat sink, it's the proper term, for this chip here. And this gets really hot, and weakens the 30-year-old plastic. And great, this is one where the metal is glued on. So yeah, to finish this, I will have to get some double-sided tape. But yeah, let's finish it to the point where I can actually use it again. So let's already power up the soldering iron. You have to remove the metal lid on the RF modulator. Like this, and there is, I need more light, and this resistor goes to the center pin of the RF connector. This has to be unsoldered, and then you have to, let's turn it around, so this has to be unsoldered, this wire has then to be soldered to there. And this wire has to be cut. That's it. It's a very easy mod. And I already performed this a couple of times. So yeah, first let's cut this wire and bend it away so that there's surely no contact. So, the other wire I cut a little bit higher. You won't see it, but I is this good? Yes, this is. So I've cut that wire. I should have brought a small length of wire. So that's going to be tinned. So just tin the wire. Like this. So next, I will unsolder the resistor. Do I have my desolder pump somewhere around? Because that would be really, really useful right now. Probably not. No, I don't. So I have to live without it. Or is it? No, it's also not over there. So, yeah, no, this solder pump. So that has to work without it. Like this. Yeah, you could also cut the wire, but I like doing my mods so that they are reversible. So next I will try to poke this tinned wire through the hole next. Yeah, and those pliers are really crappy, but they are the only ones I have right now, so they have to work. Yeah, they are really crappy. Like that. Okay, that's soldered. Now just cut that piece of wire to roughly to length. It doesn't have to be perfect. Remove the isolation. Tin this wire and tin the wire that comes from the board. Yeah, you can. Again, you can't see it, but this is not rocket science. This is simple, very simple solder work. Roughly put those wires together. Some heat and finish the solder. And it's already finished. It is supposed to look... Is it good? Yeah, I think that will be fine. So that's how it's supposed to look. Very simple mod. So now let's try to get this membrane changed. Yeah, I will get a hairdryer and be back right now. So I did get myself a hairdryer and I will try to heat this up, to loosen the glue on the sticky tape. Without ruining the metal plate. So let's see if this is already enough. Yeah, it starts to get a bit loose. And I should not have cut my fingernails before. But now these crappy pliers come in handy. Now I have to apply more heat. And I really hope that I don't ruin the metal plate. Yeah, it does sort of get loose. And please excuse the noise from the hairdryer. Does not want to come off. Really does not want to come off. And since this is the first time I do it, I have no clue how hot this must get. And I don't want to make it too hot, because I do not want to melt the plastic. And it's getting hot enough to become uncomfortable to touch. Ah, there it's loose. Okay, on this side it's loose. Yeah, and I have to get some dual-sided sticky tape tomorrow. Because that's what I've forgotten to buy today. Yeah, it's really uncomfortable to touch. But it's getting loose. Not sure if you can hear it. And it's gotten too cold again. But I'm getting there. It's only a question of time. I'm getting there. Ah, this feels great. Okay, that was easier than I expected. Now I only have to get this loose, and then I'm done with it. Yeah, went surprisingly well. I still have to get it back on somehow. So now I have to remove this crappy old one. Yeah, it's completely very fragile. Did not age very well. And I should have noted how it was in there. This way around or that way around? Around. Yeah, this seems like it fits perfectly. So can I just put this back on? That would be great. I mean, I will probably have to get some glue or sticky tape for that again, but so far this feels like it could work. Yeah, and the keys are much snappier. This actually feels cool. Yeah, so far it was much easier than I expected. So let's see if it actually works. So let's put this back together. Let's put the casing back on the RF modulator. Not that it's really necessary. This cable in there. This cable in there. Okay, let's put the case together like this. I'm not screwing it back together right now because I want to test it first. Let's pick up the power supply, wire it up to the screen, and then have a look. Okay, now comes the moment of truth. Okay. Still does boot, that's a good thing. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 0. Q. Yeah. Okay, the space key also works. That key also works, the caps shift key and the symbol shift key also works, I guess. Yes, it does. Okay, I would call that a success, a composite mod. And I changed the membrane and it seems to hold quite well. So yeah, that was... Let's put the thumbs up over here. A successful operation. I hope you enjoyed this and thanks for watching.